during pregnancy, you should start thinking about how you will feed your baby. Is your plan to directly breastfeed, to provide hand express or pump breast milk through a bottle, to provide formula, or a combination of methods? How you choose to feed your baby is your decision. All parents deserve support to meet their feeding goals without judgment. To know what nutrition will be best for your baby and family, it is important to understand some differences between breast milk and formula. Let's talk about those differences and share tips on how to prepare for breastfeeding if that is your choice. Every baby needs good, balanced nutrition to grow and develop. Both breast milk and formula provide this nutrition. Many leading medical organizations recommend exclusive breastfeeding for at least 6 months to maximize health benefits to mother and child. There are benefits of breast milk to both child and mother not found in formula. Let's start with the benefits to your baby. Breast milk adjusts over time to meet your baby's changing needs, modifying the amount of fat, protein, sugar, vitamins, and minerals as your baby grows. Breast milk provides the mother's immunity to the baby, protecting the baby from infection. Why is this so important? A newborn has a weak immune system at birth, making them very high risk of getting sick. Breastfed infants overall have fewer ear infections, viral infections, diarrheal illnesses, allergies, and asthma compared to formula-fed babies. Being breastfed has also been seen to decrease a child's long-term risk of obesity, high blood pressure, high cholesterol, and type 2 diabetes. Breast milk carries many of the body's natural chemicals, called hormones, that help relax your baby around feeds, regulate their hunger, and encourage growth. Lastly, children who breastfeed also have a lower risk of sudden infant death syndrome, or SIDS, for reasons that are not completely understood. When a baby directly breastfeeds from their parent, this also has benefits. It allows a baby to pace themselves, taking in only what they need and nothing more. Some parents also find this to be a way of bonding with and soothing their child.
I honestly, the whole time, felt like I had a superpower. I do think that it's a very close bond that you build with your child through nursing.
Breast milk is free and formula is expensive. Though breast milk can be obtained at no cost, it takes time to make and store it. And for some people, time is money. So when looking at the dollars and cents, be sure to think about how you will buy formula, where you will get it, and if needed, what programs you might qualify for to help cover the high cost. Breast milk is always available once you've established your supply. It can be pumped and stored for later use. This is because breast milk remains fresh up to 4 hours on the counter, 4 days in the refrigerator, and 4 to 6 months in a standard kitchen freezer. Keep in mind that breastfeeding is not just good for the baby, but mom too. Breastfeeding has been associated with reduced risk of postpartum depression, type 2 diabetes, breast cancer, and ovarian cancers for lactating mothers. Breastfeeding looks different for everyone. Here are 4 key steps you should take before your baby arrives to give yourself the best chance of success. Identify a support system of 1 or more individuals before you deliver. These individuals should provide you with encouragement, advocacy, and possibly even hands-on help with breastfeeding once the baby arrives. Examples of support people include your partner, family and friends, a peer support group who can offer advice on shared experiences, and lactation professionals within your community. Schools and employers are legally required to provide time and space to pump. So ask where the lactation spaces will be for you when you return after having your baby. You will need a breast pump. Early on, a breast pump can help you build your milk supply, and later, it will allow you to store milk to be given when you are away from your baby. Most parents receive a pump through their insurance company. Some parents receive this pump just after delivery in the hospital. other women may qualify to get a pump through their local Women, Infants, and Children WIC office. Lastly, be aware that many moms have unique challenges to overcome in the first weeks of breastfeeding. It is important to know who you can ask for help to navigate these obstacles if they happen to you. Common breastfeeding concerns are worrying about having a low milk supply, having trouble latching baby, and experiencing pain. If you encounter these challenges or others, please seek professional help early and often. Right here in Philadelphia, there is a growing and energetic community of Black families who breastfeed. Let us see, support, and celebrate these families and those organizations working to empower them. If you are interested in learning more about breastfeeding, speak openly with your healthcare team or a lactation professional to build your personal plan, ideally before your baby arrives.